Hello, are you ready for some techno babble this morning? Hello, this is Nicole Homa with Shield Bar Marketing, here talking about a subdomain in your URL. Now, for the average person, that probably didn't make sense, and hopefully I can break it down for you. So with a URL, so the actual item that you type up in your browser, like www.standoutpro.com, that's your URL, whether it's Google, whether it's Bing, whomever. That is what most people think of as a domain name. But did you know with a domain name, there are actually 8 different parts of it? Now today we're just gonna talk about one part, the subdomain. Now when you're talking about the 8 different parts, there are actually the protocol, the subdomain, the domain name itself, the port, the path, the query, the parameters, and the fragment. But like I said, today we're just gonna go over the subdomain part. So if you look at the domains behind me, standoutpro.com and gift.standoutpro.com, the part that we're talking about is the part I have underlined under gift. Gift is where the www dot normally would go when people are thinking about accessing a domain. Now, you can actually change that as long as you have access to your domain name servers or your DNS. See, I told you there was gonna be techno babble today. But within the DNS, you can actually go in and do gift or get it now, ABC, whatever you wanna put in there besides the www. So for me, I actually have the domain name standoutpro.com, which for right now actually redirects to ticket sales. But the gift.standoutpro.com, same domain, different subdomain, actually redirects to where people can get my LinkedIn 7 Simple Steps to Stand Out guide for free. So depending on what you're wanting to accomplish, you very well may have one or more subdomains set up on your actual domain name. You can do this because then you only purchase one domain, you access your DNS, and then you can add the different subdomains in there pointing to different IP addresses. Now, the only thing here is you will need different hosting accounts for each website that you're gonna host, but if you're redirecting to say like Eventbrite, like I do with standoutpro.com, then you don't need to buy hosting for that. You're just doing a forward of the domain. So I'll be discussing some of the other things like forwarding, the path and ports and things like that in upcoming videos. But for right now, think about the subdomain, think about how it would work in your sales funnel if you need it. And while you're online, go check out gift.standoutpro.com and get your free download from me on 7 simple steps to stand out on LinkedIn. Make it a standout week. Talk soon.